Quality assurance with regards to the Boeing 787 has been a topic since production for the widebody first began. However, it has been ever-present even more so in recent years and especially in recent months. Now it has put Boeing into a rather tricky situation.
Bimble 851, turn right, heading 180. 14 Papa, turn right 245, report localizer established 27.
Last week, the Federal Aviation Administration, or more commonly referred to as the FAA, came to the decision and announced that it had fined Boeing a total of US $5.4 million following Boeing not meeting the Terms Act that were outlined in a settlement back in 2015. The amount was only added by a further US $1.2 million to bring the total past $6.6 million, following the FAA deeming this was adequate to also settle a total of two other safety-related cases that Boeing were involved in. In a statement, the FAA administration, Steve Dixon, commented on Boeing's failing to meet what was required of them by saying, "Boeing failed to meet all of its obligations under the settlement agreement, and the FAA is holding Boeing accountable by imposing additional penalties. I've reiterated to Boeing's leadership time and time again that the company must prioritize safety and regulatory compliance, and that the FAA will always put safety first in all of its decisions." This has been a comment that's received quite a fair amount of scrutiny over on social media, considering the FAA played a significant part in certifying, or should I say not certifying, the 737 MAX correctly, and rather allowing Boeing to handle most of the certification process, and in turn, allowing critical safety features to simply slip through the hands of the regulator. The Boeing 787 is continuing to face scrutiny as well from many people, including regulators themselves, who note that Boeing are ignoring quality assurance tests and allowing cracks, quite literally cracks, and more to slip through due to the added pressure to deliver the type to customers. Delays, thanks to all these checks, have meant that the planned production has also been altered and messed around with, which is obviously the last thing an aircraft manufacturer wants when trying to pump out a highly successful plane, especially when delivery delays and more transfer over and impact other aircraft within their portfolio. It's not just the 787 that feels the effects of this. Boeing has remained adamant, though, that they've always looked to improve to work thoroughly on ensuring no further flaws are found with the Boeing 787 moving forward. However, external questions from the media and more have let the pressure continue to build and mount on them as more flaws are found with every passing month, leading to more inspections, and if at the worst case scenario, not only does it halt production completely, but of course, I would argue at the very, very worst, it can lead the aircraft to potentially be grounded to see these inspections carried out. That is the complete worst case scenario for something like this. We've seen groundings before that have completely ruined an airline like that of Norwegian, albeit that was with the Trent 1000 engines. However, it is still just as much a problem for Boeing and the aircraft airline itself. What are your thoughts on the latest troubles with Boeing, especially being fined by the FAA some $6.6 million? Feel free to let me know, and as always, thanks for tuning into this video, and I will see you in the next one.